Hello and welcome to our day two recap of OLC Ideate. Thank you for joining us for just a delightful day here with our first synchronous day of activities. So we started this morning. If you're wondering why I'm wearing the same outfit as I was wearing in Monday's recap, it's because I made that early this morning after taking a look at what we had done asynchronously in the Canvas course, getting a sense for the videos people had watched, and kind of preparing for what we were going to need to do today. We kicked off at 9 a.m. with just a really energetic and inspiring introduction from OLC board members, Kim Clyatt-Long and Kate Yordahl, as well as OLC CEO Jennifer Mathis. Each and every one of them highlighted the importance of community and inspiration in the work that we do and the work we're doing together at this OLC Ideate focused on diversity, equity, and inclusion in digital learning environments. And throughout the day, we saw that. We saw Karen Costa start us off at 10 a.m. with just making us feel so cared for, talking about trauma and trauma-informed teaching, making sure that we know that we're aware of the trauma our students are experiencing. And in 2020, the trauma that we're experiencing too, collectively as a whole, whether we necessarily feel and acknowledge it or not. We also heard from Elaine Villanueva Bernal, who talked to us about environmental justice and how what we're experiencing locally may differ from what we're experiencing globally. She pointed out different things like, the Flint water crisis and how there are 2 million refugees who are refugees because of global climate issues driving them from their homes. How can we bring those topics home to our students? How can we make those things real? She was very, very good at showing us how to visualize those things and just contextualize them in not only face-to-face environments, but also online. We had Janue Johnson talk about looking back to look forward and take us through a really in-depth reflection of our equity journey, where we are, where we are going, the things that matter to us. One of the things that mattered to me was she had us reflect on and recognize our ancestors and acknowledge some of the people who brought us here today. So I thought of my grandfather. I have a PhD. I'm from a small town. I shouldn't be here. Had he not taken on some, kind of contract television and radio repair work and given me $1,500 to go to community college, I wouldn't be sitting here right now. So it's important to acknowledge the people who helped us get to where we are, the land which we sit on, which is indigenous before us, etc. That was a really powerful, powerful experience. We had a bit of fun with Dr. Angela Gibson and Madison Hanson as they took us through Maslow before Bloom and how we can apply the Maslow before Bloom concepts and how we need to focus on students' true, like, physiological and mental and physical needs, like food, shelter. You know, if a student can't eat, can a student learn? If a student isn't sure where they're going to sleep at night, are they really going to be able to focus on learning objectives? We had a little bit of fun. So if you ever, throughout the course of the rest of the week, hear us refer to Dr. Maslow Overbloom, you'll know that that was an attendee at that session. And we did have a good time while also digging into really, really important things. After that, Cherise McBride took us through leveraging sociocultural knowledge to humanize online learning experiences. She really took us through a series of thinking exercises and provocations. And what do we focus on? What do we amplify? What do we what do we value and what do we talk about? So when we use the resilience narrative, what does that mean? Are we expecting people to be resilient as opposed to doing the good work, the hard work of changing the systems that force them to be resilient, force us to be resilient? You know, what does that mean? So a lot of really good, hard, reflective, introspective work happened in that session. The chat room was very active. A lot of people really thinking deeply about things they had thought previously and kind of changing some notions. And thank you to the people who shared experiences that helped many of us see things a little bit differently in that time. Jennifer Nichols, after that, shared some really powerful playbooks and field guides for inclusive design and different ways we can look beyond universal design for learning and really, really involve and include multiple stakeholders' voices and individuals in the design process. And then we went into our evening social where Maddie Shelgren and Angela Gunder took us through just a really interesting exercise, a couple of exercises actually, where we were challenged in breakout rooms to accomplish tasks with very rigid challenges. So thank you to the people who volunteered and jumped right in and said, yes, I will facilitate that. Absolutely. Go watch the video. I can't encourage you enough. It is designed so that you can play asynchronously and you can try to go through and see what Maddie challenged them to do in these breakout rooms. But throughout the day, you know, as our CEO Jennifer Mathis and our board member Kay Iordahl said at the beginning of the day, this is about community. These events we put on at OLC are about community. It's about helping and partnering and making sure that we're having the conversations that really help our community grow and thrive. So what we experienced today and what I hope you'll take away as you watch the recordings and participate in the asynchronous activities in the Canvas course is that what we saw today was consistent participation from our community in really difficult subjects. So thank you to those who kind of showed up and dug deep into things that weren't necessarily easy to think about or share. And to those of you who are at home participating in the Canvas course or doing the reflective activities, thank you to you for doing this thinking and this work. We also saw a lot of people opening doors and modeling openness and bravery, sharing experiences, talking about things that may help others understand different situations differently. So really looking forward to tomorrow's Wednesday program, and we'll have a morning kickoff at 9 a.m. Eastern time. We'll hear from partners, board members. We have a number of salons again throughout the day tomorrow, and we will hear from Every Learner Everywhere, the CEO, Jessica Williams. We'll hear from Carly Lasowski from Wayne State University on self-care, vulnerability, and online communities and personal and professional practice. And we've just got a really good morning lined up for you. So we hope to see you then. Thanks for joining today, and we'll see you tomorrow.